is like, whatever you're gonna do, I'm gonna kill you. Whatever.
Welcome. Hello.
Thank you very much.
This is where the interview starts.
It's nice to be here. It's a wonderful place to be.
Do you like it?
I have the PowerPoint background on my name.
Do you want to take that home with you?
Can I?
Sure.
No, you're lying.
Do I look like I'm lying?
It's too heavy.
We'll give it to you if okay. You really want it.
I can do a picture of it now.
Sure.
Okay. Got it.
What if a girl selfies though? Oh, hi.
Hey. Hey. Hey, hi guys.
Can I filter that?
Hi, studio. Hi, Hollywood. Young
Wait, you're
studio.
Now my favorite guest ever. These are the kind of interviews that I love.
Yes.
When people are just relaxed, they're whatever.
Bullshitting around. Yes,
exactly. And I love it when people swear to you in an interview. It's good. It means you're getting comfortable.
I will pretend this sofa, it's comfortable.
It's really not, is it?
So soft and smooth and slippery.
It's like a deep, dark hole. You get in it, you don't get out. Welcome.
Thank you.
You are in the most expensive TV show, or not even TV show ever made.
Master Markham, a moment, please.
The story is incredible, and I know you've talked about it a lot, but for people who don't know, you didn't speak English or much English 6 months before you got this role. You got put into doing archery, I mean, kung fu, I mean, horseback riding. I mean, they threw you in it. Actually, when they sent me, Netflix sent me, like, all the press notes and the screeners and all that, and they actually sent me your workout regimen. And it says 3 minutes of crunches, followed by like 3 minutes of pull-ups, followed by...
No, no, it's like was intense, was the biggest effort I've ever did in my life.
Really?
And I did, at the beginning, you know, I love to drink. Normally.
Well, I know, because so Zhu was here and she told me that the first time you guys met,
yeah.
You took her out for tequila.
Yeah, we just saw each other. Great. I was like, let's do some tequila shots.
Oh, so it was your idea.
No, it was...
Wow. And so yeah. This was like right before you started shooting together?
Yeah.
Wow.
But I guess he was just being himself and being Italian.
I get her drunk.
You did?
That's the best way to be confident with an actress.
Now?
You know, we have to be... so close. What is the best way? Maybe some 10 hours of Stanislavski or no. Get drunk with tequila. That's the best way to get close with
Forget
someone.
Forget the method acting. Just use the alcohol is the way
it
to do
was
it.
Actually, yes.
It, yeah. So does it work? Does it create chemistry? Does it?
It's a good chemistry. I mean, to be an Italian and a Chinese, it's a good match. And this is beautiful because it's the reality in the show. You know, so that's a good thing.
Yeah.
But yes, you know, so the fact that I love to drink tequila doesn't match so much with this diet and the regimen.
So what did you do?
I basically had to train for like 10 hours a day.
Yeah.
And then after 10 hours, including 2 hours of English, of course, I had to dip my body in the bathtub full of salts. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to move a finger the day after. I mean,
in three weeks,
they changed my body. I changed with them my body.
Well, speaking of which, one of the first scenes in the pilot, we see your body. I mean, we see quite a bit of your body.
Which one?
You looked great.
When
you're in the shower. I remember that scene. I don't know why you don't remember it, but I remember.
In the shower, with the water from the elephant.
Yeah.
That's it. Yeah. That was a scene. We have a lot of animals in this show, guys. of animals that make you shower. And we love be showered by animals, by weird animals. Have you ever been showered by an ostrich? It's an experience,
yes,
guys.
You
it's an experience. But yes, we have an ostrich on the show. That's true.
You do?
Yeah, we do.
What were you the best at? The horseback riding, the kung fu? What do you think
horseback
you met?
Riding.
Yeah.
Running with a horse, with an animal that trusts you. And you understand after 5-6 months that you're riding the same horse, he trusts you. And you know him. And then I had this great shot at the end of the season. You will see there is this war, and I have this huge battlefield, 2 square kilometers in Malaysia, all set up with 300 extras fighting each other. Smokes, fire. My action was, Renzo, this is pretty difficult. You have to ride as fast as you can there. And I was like, really? I have to go there? Okay. I mean, that was direct ring. It's like you are there and coming from the top of the hill, down the valley, through an army of real people, stunt guys are fighting. That was like my best memory in all the shooting. And the reason why I'm saying that horseback riding is like the best thing I've learned.
Will you also shoot in your home country?
Yes, in Venice.
Was it strange? Did you show people around? Did you say, okay, I got this, I'm gonna take you to the best restaurant, I'm gonna take you to the best, you know?
I did that.
You
did
that,
you yes. After the fifth cappuccino, eating a steak. Yeah, I just wanna say something, guys. You cannot eat meat and drink cappuccino together.
Why?
It's something really bad for like the meaning of food, of like the taste. A chef, talk to anyone that has a minimum knowledge of food. You can do whatever you want. But like a big burger, it's like marshmallow in the burger. You would do it? You would put marshmallow in the burger?
It's not a bad idea. You've given me an idea, actually. I'm gonna be going. This is the American way. We put everything
on
the burger.
No, I know.
No, so you mean like during the burger experience, you don't have a cappuccino? What about after, when you want to have your coffee
you
after?
You can do whatever. I mean, you can
just
do whatever you want.
Time.
Just if you're, I have a friend in Italy that actually moved out from a restaurant because he was beside a guy that was like eating meatballs and having a cappuccino at the same time. So you're eating meat and you're drinking milk and coffee at the same time. That mix for an Italian guy, it's like can be horrifying.
Okay, so I have a question for you. I think it's one of the, it's in the pilot. I think it was somebody who's talking to you and says, I think it's one of your instructors, and they say, there's like yin and yang, obviously, because we're talking about Chinese culture, and they say in the character, Marco Polo has too much yang and not enough ying, which I looked it up, and yin means your sort of shady side, your dark side, and yang is your sunny side?
Not really. I mean, it can be, there is the, no, I mean, I don't know it.
Yeah.
First of all, so I'm not gonna tell you about yin and yang and the philosophy of the Chinese people, no, of Taoism. But it's like yin and yang for 100 Eyes, that it was my teacher.
Yeah.
It's like the presence. So I can't remember which is yin and which is yang, but when he does...
He said you had too much yang.
Too much yang. So too much yang is too much like presence, energy. You have much energy, but you have to control it.
Right.
So, you know, it's like the power and the head.
I was gonna ask you what you have more of, yin or yang, but I already know the answer. You got a lot of yang.
Yeah,
it's a compliment.
It's not true. I'm shy.
I can tell. I might. This could make you shy. This question. So Marco Polo. So it was Kokuchin. Is it Kokuchin?
Yeah.
The love of his life, basically.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I read this that the actual Marco Polo took a piece of her dress
at the end of it. Well, yeah, back to Italy.
Back to Italy after being in China for how many years? Like 25 or 30 years.
Yeah, 20 years.
Which I thought was so romantic, and girls are gonna love that story.
That's
What's the
true.
Most romantic thing you've ever done? For someone, have you ever taken a piece of someone's dress? Have you ever done anything like that?
Yes, I robbed them. My girl, and then room, and then make a painting on my wall, like with this dress.
I guess it doesn't translate.
And I thought it was romantic.
20th century, it doesn't translate. It was romantic at the time. But what's the most romantic thing you've ever done?
Well, I was, how do you say, courting a girl?
Courting, yeah.
Courting. I was courting my
like
actual girlfriend.
So it's out.
And bringing. The big flowers, the yellow flowers,
roses
that turns with the sun.
Oh, sunflowers. Good choice.
The sunflower? Yeah.
Good choice. Better
it's
not to go with the standard
roses.
Girls don't want that. You want
to look.
Yeah. Clever.
But I never. I mean, I did it like for 2 months because I met my girlfriend. She was like outstanding, but she was with a guy. So, and I'm not the kind of guy. I'm really respectful about these things because I have a bad story between my two best friends.
And then I want to hear that story, but go on.
Okay. No, but every week I was bringing him his mailbox, and I was leaving a flower there, but not signing myself. I was not like saying that I was with me, that it was me. Just like to, you know, you're a beauty, you're the most beautiful girl I've ever seen. So just, I never wrote my name on it. So it was like totally pure.
Did she know?
Now she knows.
Now she knows. Is it now your girlfriend? It's the girlfriend?
Yeah.
And when did you reveal it? I know. I mean, American men, take note.
And
this is the way to do it. You don't go for the dozen roses and put your name on it. You get a little subtle, you know? Okay, so when did you reveal it? When did you reveal that it was you? How did that happen? So
she's
broke up with the guy.
We did a movie together.
Oh.
It's pretty much like
That's the way. That's how you see the deal.
I know. I mean, it's a commonplace, but yes. And we did a movie together. We had to be together. While she was shooting, she left that guy she was in. And
because of you?
No. Because I was
sure.
No, because I was totally in that movie. I was like no romantic at all. I was like super bad guy coming out for prison. So eventually, she fell in love with that guy, and she laughed at me now. You say, you're not the big and masculine guy you pretended to be in that movie.
You're no Yang.
No.
You're more
I'm
Yin.
Ying. And you're more Yin.
It's Yin. Oh my gosh. You're the most, I think you're about the most fun guest we've ever had.
Poor you.
Can you teach me a little Kung Fu? Is there anything you can teach me?
Well, differences between, now all the like Kung Fu community gonna hate me because I'm doing
there's
this.
A committee.
But yeah. you can do, you know, the mantis stand that is pretty present in the show.
Yeah.
It's just this. It's incredible. It's this. And you see, you know, a boxer would say, yeah. The guard is like this, you know, and you cover your face. So yeah. It's pretty much logic. But when you see this,
you're like, this guy's messed up. He's yeah, going to
exactly.
mess with me.
Exactly.
This guy knows stuff.
And
this guy's
there is
got
this
some
beautiful
tricks.
Stance that Chin Han does in the show that is this one, and that is like this, that is like the praying mantis, and then he does this.
Ooh.
That is like,
you don't know where it's
whatever
coming
you're
from.
Gonna do, I'm gonna kill you. Whatever. Even just because I can do this and I'm pretend to be serious.
I'm actually getting a little mesmerized.
And this is about this is all about the wrist. It's all about they will never. I mean, they do not punch this. You know.
Yeah.
It's. Pretty not effective. But if you try to punch me now, like whatever, do something, and I can do this. And you know the wrist block your punch and you can grab it and do whatever you want. And at the first time someone told this, it's like someone tell you this, it's like now come on, this is bullshit, this can't be real. When you actually see one of these guys doing Kung Fu, you're afraid as hell because this guy with two fingers can kill you. And you know the beautiful thing that I had this huge stunt group of people, Chinese, Japanese, none of them was like super fit. It's not true. You don't need those muscles. We
right.
don't need like, whoa, super beautiful muscle. They were so skinny, I mean, not super skinny, of course. The power, it's all about, it's more a philosophy, you know? It's not
yeah.
it's not just like being cool doing Kung Fu, even because if you want to master it, you have to study it like for 10 years. It's pretty much a philosophy.
Wow.
And John Fusco, the creator of the show, has a passion and a great experience with martial arts. So he was there and he wanted to bring the martial arts in a poetic way in the show.
Wow. Mm. Amazing story. If this isn't a reason to watch the show, the 90 million budget, the whatever else,
I thought me.
It's all
well, 90 million budget, I don't know.
I mean, but this, I mean, the show, it's going to be epic. Everybody knows it's going to be epic, but it's great having you. You speak English better than a lot of Americans, by the way.
Yeah, really?
You do, you really do. You know how to tell a story better.
You should have met me like 5 months ago.
Well, that's the incredible part about it. It was great having you here. Thanks for coming in. Let's go do a tequila shot. What was that thing? Wait.